In the last video, I derived the family of second order Runge Kutta methods. In this video, I want to continue and show you how you can get specific second order Runge Kutta methods, including the modified Euler method. So remember, we're integrating the differential equation x dot equals f of t x, and we're moving from a time t equals tn to a time t equals tn plus delta t. The second order Runge Kutta method is a two-stage method. We compute k1 equals delta t f of tn xn, and then k2 equals delta t f of tn plus alpha delta t xn plus beta k1. So alpha and beta then are two parameters. And then xn plus 1 equals xn plus a times k1 plus b times k2. So xn plus 1 equals xn plus some weighted average of k1 and k2. In order for this method to be accurate to second order in time, so containing all terms up to including delta t squared, we derive that a plus b has to be equal to 1, alpha times b has to be 1 half, and beta times b also has to be 1 half. Okay, now let's use this method, and we can derive the modified Euler's method. So what are the values of these parameters for the modified Euler's method? If you remember, xn plus 1 equals xn plus the average value of the slopes at the two endpoints, or delta t times the average value. That would mean that a equals b equals 1 half. So for the modified Euler's method, a equals b equals 1 half. And then alpha b equals 1 half. B is 1 half, so alpha has to be 1. And beta b equals 1 half. B is 1 half, so beta has to be 1. So we have to have alpha equal beta equal to 1. Okay, so then what is the method? So the modified Euler's method then has k1 equals delta t f of tn xn. And then in the second stage, k2 equals delta t times f of tn plus alpha delta t. Alpha is 1, so tn plus delta t. And xn plus beta k1, beta is 1, so xn plus k1. And then finally, xn plus 1 then is equal to xn, and a and b are 1 half, so plus 1 half k1 plus k2. That's exactly what we had derived before when I discussed the modified Euler's method. So to show you that this is a family of methods, we can derive another method that's called the midpoint method. Okay. The midpoint method, from the name, means that we want to be looking at the middle of the interval. Okay. So the middle of the interval corresponds to alpha equal to 1 half, right? So we would like to have alpha equal to 1 half. Okay, so we evaluate at tn plus 1 half delta t. So if alpha equals 1 half, then b has to be 1 from the third equation, right? If alpha is 1 half, b is 1. If b is 1, then beta is also 1 half. And if b is 1, then a is 0, okay? So just by specifying this one value that we want to evaluate f at tn plus 1 half delta t, all the other values fall out. Okay, that's what these constraints are doing for us. So then what does this method look like? So again, K1 is the same. So K1 equals delta T F of Tn Xn. K2 equals delta T F of Tn plus 1/2 delta T, right? That was our choice of alpha equals 1/2. And then beta is also equal to 1/2. So we have an Xn plus 1/2 K1. Okay? And then our integration step, Xn plus 1, is equal to Xn plus the value of A then is 0. And the value of B is 1. So it's just Xn plus, all we need is K2 here. We don't need K1. So also a second order Runge Kutta method. So in fact, the accuracy of these two methods are more or less the same. They're accurate to second order. Two different methods. You can have other methods besides these ones, right? One of them I give you as a reading problem. Both of the methods are fine. I've used the modified Euler's method before. But these days, you know, MATLAB gives you functions that integrate for you. So typically, you would not code this up. Though, you know, basically, I did get my PhD from coding up the modified Euler's method, so not too bad. Let me summarize. There's a family of second-order Runge Kutta methods that are all basically equivalent in their accuracy, but they have to satisfy certain constraints. Here's two of them, the modified Euler's method and the midpoint method. I'm Jeff Chasnoff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.